We're on Avodah Zarah, Perek Hey, Mishnah Yud Bet, 12th and final Mishnah in the 5th and last chapter of Masechet Avodah Zarah. And this we're going to finish Masechet Avodah Zarah. Our Mishnah deals with halachot of kashering. How do you use halokeach klei tashmish minagoy? You buy klei tashmish, vessels for food from the non-Jew. How do you kasher them? What's the process that a Jew has to do in order to use them? So in order to understand this, we have to look at Bamidbar, Perek Lamed Gimel, okay, and get to Psukim Chafalev Chaper Chav Gimel, right? And this is from the Giulei Klei Midian. After the Jews, they had a war with the people of Midian, and they conquered all kinds of booty, booty. And so the Torah says, "Vayomer Elazar Kohen El Anshei Tzava Ba'im LeMelchama." Elazar Kohen said to the people that came back from the war, "Zot Chukata Torah Shetiva Hashem HaMoshe." This is the law of the Torah that God said to Moshe. Ach. However, howbeit, et hazahav, hakesef, hanechoshet, barzel, okay, the gold, silver, the copper, barzel, iron, bedil, tin, ofar, the lead, kol devar sheyavo be'esh, everything that asher yavo be'esh, that comes into fire, taviru be'esh v'tahir, you have to pass through fire. Ach bedmei nida yitchata. Nonetheless, it should be yitchata, purified in mei nida, the waters of the nida. And anything that doesn't come into fire, okay, you should put it through water. This is a general principle explained in the Torah of what we call kibol o kach pot o. I'm going to write that down for you. Okay, we'll dedicate it at the end, just so you know. I'm going to put it in Hebrew. Kibol o kach pot o. It's a very important rule in the laws of kashrut. Okay, let's just move it over so you can see it. Kibol o, this is where livloa. Libloa means to swallow. As food is absorbed, paste is absorbed, kach poto, that's how you get it out. So if I've got this glass cup and I made coffee in it, but non-Jew, if I bought it from non-Jew and he used it to make treif lard coffee or whatever, the same force that caused the taste of the non-kosher wine or whatever to enter into the walls of this glass will cause it to come out. And it depends on the quality of the item. So you notice in the Torah that we said, the Torah gave a specific list of things. All of these are metal. So then the Chazal come in and say, what do you do if it's not metal? We had in the last case, wood and stone, etc., etc. That's why you have Torah Shabbat Peh. So says the Torah, then that's step one. Kibolo kachpot. You got to get out what you have. And we'll see that there's a second step as well. Halokeh kli tashmish min hagoy, says the Mishnah. If you buy items, usable items, food items, shel seuda, food items, meal items from a non-Jew, et shedarko lehatbil, yatbil. Those things that are used for dipping, you shall dip. Lehag'il, those things that are used for haga'ala, boiling. You might have heard that term, hagola, haga'ala. Haga'ala means to boil something. The way you undo it is you boil the same way. You might, you might have gone, like on Pesach, there's a program that in the shul they're doing haga'ala. So people do this all the time on their own. You can do it at home, it's not so hard. Yag'il, so if it's used to boil, then you should boil. Lilabein ba'or, if it's used lavan, lilabein, to make white in the fire, yilabein ba'or. You have to make it white in the fire. Let's look at the bar tenura, okay? Etchdak lakbil, kolomar, meaning, kli haro'i litaher bitvila, things that are purified with washing. Ve'enot zorich tikun acher, and if it doesn't have to be used in any other way. Kigon, tashmisho, ayadei tzonen. It's using for cool water. I've got this water bottle. Okay, people didn't have it. If it was used for cold, it was used for cold. Okay, it was only used for cold, so therefore all you have to do is wash it out. Yatbil. Okay? B'mikveh hakasher litvilat isha utvilato matiro. Meaning it has to be cleaned, and then you have to bring it to the mikvah. Let's see, why do you have to bring it to the mikvah? So this is the second part of the Torah says. Ach b'mei nida yitchata. It has to be brought into the purified waters of sprinkling, i.e., this is what we call tvila, tovelin. Okay, so there's a two-prong process. Non-kosher item, you have to kasher it. But then you have to tovel it. You have to bring it. This is what's called chukat ha-Torah. Zot chukat ha-Torah. This is a din d'oraita. You have to kasher a Jew. If they buy items from a non-Jew, first they have to be cleaned. They have to be kashered. And even if they're clean 100%, you bought it from a store, they have to be tovel. It's a chuk, zot chukat ha-Torah. And for a Jew to use an item that belongs to another Jew or belongs to himself that wasn't ach b'meni da itchata, that wasn't brought b'meni da, that's what we call a bitul aseh. It's a nullification of an aseh, of a chiyuv aseh in the Torah. Big problem. Some people, I don't know why, I've seen that they don't take this halakha of tolling seriously. It's a din d'oraita, you have to do it. Okay? That's all you could say. But, so that's if you kashered it, darkol lahagil, if it's only used cold, then all you have to do is clean it, obviously, and then tovel it. Lahagil, if you boil in it, kagon yorot ukideirot, like pots, and your rez is a large pot, you know, kideirot, the large vats, pots. They're boiled out. You should boil it up. So how do you do that? Okay, you put in boiling water, and you leave the boiling water in it a little bit. Okay, you put it in a boiling pot and you leave it there a little bit. That's how you do hagala. I'm sure if you look on the internet and YouTube, you can find hagala examples. You have to remove the chulda, the rust and the sediment. Then that, so you remove the rest. So what's step one? Clean it. Step two, haga'ala. Put it in a pot of boiling water. Step three, v'achar kach matbilan b'mikvah kasher l'tvitat isha. Then you do tovel it, matbilan. See the word tovel, tovel, matbilan, v'hein mutarin, and then it's mutar. That's a three-step process for something that was used hot. L'labein ba'or, but if somebody uses white hot, then yalbein ba'or, you have to use it as white hot. Kelim shemishtamshim b'yedei ha'or, but yavesh, things that are used in fire, dry fire, without sauce, i.e., it's not a soup pot, as we're going to see. Then you have to do libun. You might have heard that term, libun. You have to burn it out. For example, hashafud. Shafud is a shipud is a skewer. Askala. Let's look up that word. Askala. The lattice work of a fireplace, the grating of a grill. Oh, okay. The grate of your grill. So if you have a grating of a grill, we're going to see that you have to do melab mambar. You have to do libun in fire. What about a sakin, a knife? Because the knives were not used in hot, they were used in cold. Shafa, you lashuf means you rub it off. If you hitar, how you do that? Okay. First of all, libun, ach you need sotzot nitazimahim. So it has to be so white hot that sparks are coming off. And then vachakach mapilan, then you do tevila. What about a knife? Shafa. So how do you do shafa? You rub it clearly. So this is something called ni'itza bekarka. They would no'atza bekarka kasha. You drive it into the ground eser pa'amim, 10 times in ein ba'gumot, if it doesn't have perforations, and then rochel batzonein. So that's what they would do. They would, you know, put it in the ground 10 times, or the best way, mashchiza be'eben ha'mashchezet. You sharpen it with a sharpening stone, and then rochel ba'afilu rotchim. That's the way you clean it. Ve'im hayu ba'gumot, if it has like perforations, melabna. Okay, then you have to do libun. Okay, and all of them, anything that you use, okay, it was used when it was cold or mutar. He's saying here is bidi eved. If you use these kelim, okay, before you kasher them, okay, the food is mutar. Why is the food mutar? The notain tam lifgam mutar, because we assume that any taste, so you have to lechatchila kasher it. But if you didn't kasher it, we assume that the taste after 24 hours that's infused into a vessel is called notain. Oh, I lost my place. Notain tam, but it's notain tam lifgam. It's bad taste. Why is it bad taste? Because once things are 24 hours old, it tastes bad. So therefore, the taste yes is absorbed and it's reinfused into the food, but it's bad taste. V'Torah lo asra al kedera bat yoma. And this is the Torah only prohibited non-kosher food, a pot that's bat yoma, that's less than 24 hours old. So very often, when you ask the rabbi, I use my milchik pot for fleishik, whatever, the first thing I'll ask you is, well, did you wash it with soap? Because soap is tam lifgam, tastes terrible. And the second thing I'm about to ask you is, how long ago was the last time you used the pot? Because he wants to know, is it notain tam lishvach or notain tam lifgam? Right, we can't do all halachot kashrut in one Mishnah, we're just learning the Mishnah. But this is just a nice intro, a nice introduction to the ideas of tevila, haga'ala, and kashering, libun. And it's a great way to end off our study of Masechet Avodah Zarah. We'll dedicate Salik Masechet Avodah Zarah. We'll dedicate our learning to my memory of my father, Rab Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. Comments, questions? If you've enjoyed the learning, you have suggestions, email me at rspolter@gmail.com. Have a great day.